Hey guys, today I'm going to talk about how we can save related data using Entity Framework Core. I'm going to use the same database that I used for my last demo, but this time instead of loading related data, we are saving related data, right? So what are we going to do? We are going to save a publisher, and then we're going to save books associated with the publisher, and then the sales associated with the publisher, associated with the books who are associated with the publisher. And we're just going to do this in one save changes. We're not going to insert records, save publisher separately and take the publisher ID and put it in publisher ID and then add the book ID to sales. We're just going to do everything in one go. So I'm going to use the same solution. In my last video, I talked about how we can use eager loading for loading related data. So I'm going to copy the same function and I'm going to call it as post publisher details. And I'm going to keep it as HTTP get. But before I get the response, what I would like to do, I would like to save publisher and then books related to the publisher and the sales related to the books who are related to the publisher. And our function is not going to have, is not going to take any parameters because we are inserting records. For now, let's make this as zero because it'll give you an error. So yeah, let's go ahead and create a publisher. I'm gonna call it as publisher. It's a new publisher. And my publisher's name is Harper and Brothers. They are in New York City. So I'm gonna say city as New York City. This is where they are located at. And New York City is in New York State. New York State. And the country is obviously United States, USA. Okay, so what are we doing here? We created publisher. We created an object of publisher. Now let's go ahead and add it into DB context so that we can save it into our database. So to do that, I'm gonna say context publisher add a new publisher, which is the publisher which we created, and eventually save that publisher into our database. Save changes so that it will save the publisher into database. And I would like to see the same publisher in JSON format. So I'm gonna say that let's pull the same publisher so that we can see it in our JSON format. Sweet. Let's run this and add our Harper and Brothers publisher into database. And then as we go along, I'll add books and sales into same publisher. So when I run this in JSON format, it will show the publisher that we just added into our database. So what I'm gonna do, I want to add books associated with this publisher, and I don't want to create books separately. I would like to create a new publisher who has books associated with it. So before we add publisher into our publisher DB context, I'm gonna create some books. I'm gonna say this is book one, and this book's name. Book's title is Good Night Moon. Good Night Moon 1, and it was published now. date time now. Nice. And I'm going to create another book, which will be also published by the same publisher. I'm gonna say it's a Good Night Moon 2. Good Night Moon 2. Nice, and it is published at the same time. So before we, like I said, before we add publisher into a DB context, what I'm gonna say, this publisher has some books that we would like to add. So when I say add, I'd like to add book one, and then we will add book two into our publisher, the same publisher. Now when I run it, it's going to have two books. It'll create a new publisher and it will have two books associated with it. Let's see. So when I run it, you can see that it created a new publisher with publisher ID 33, and then it used that publisher ID to create a book, a new book with the same publisher ID, and the same publisher ID it used for another book. It created two more books with Goodnight Moon 1 and 2 with publisher ID 33. All right, so let's go one step deeper. What I'm gonna do, I'm gonna create another publisher who has two more books and who has sales associated with the same books. So what I'm going to do, before we add this books into our publisher, I would like to create some sales. I'm gonna copy some code from here and put it here. So what I'm gonna do is I created two sales objects who has a quantity, and we have store ID, and then there is order number, pay terms, order date. And now we should associate these sales to book one and book two, and then add books these to the publishers, and then save our changes. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna say the book one that I created, book one has some sales, and I would like to add that sale as sale one, and book two has some sales, and I'm gonna add that into my book two and call it as sale two. Sweet. And then add this book one and book two who already have some sales, and then add those books into our publisher. So when I run it, our books will have some sales for the publisher that we're adding. So you can see that it created another publisher with another books with 34 ID. And then you can see that it created more sales with the book ID that it created, it associated with it. And our book ID 38 also has some sale, 34, and it has book ID associated with it. All right, so this is how you can create relational data, and then just call save changes to add the objects that you're associated with each other. But this is not how normally we get data, right? Like we normally get data in JSON format. So to test that, what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna use Postman tool here. And I already have this post publisher function, which takes publisher as parameter and then adds into DB context. So I'm gonna call this function from my Postman tool, and I'm gonna pass JSON, which is related JSON, and see if it creates related data associated with this publisher. So first I'm going to copy this link and put it here. Say it's a post function, and it takes some body in JSON format, and I'm gonna copy this and paste it here. I'm gonna purify it, and this JSON, you know, it's new data, so this new data will not have any IDs. IDs will be created by database, and entity framework will take care of it. So only thing that you need to do is to create JSON, is to create proper JSON and send it to your web API, and that will and that will take care of creating relational data for your database. I'm gonna beautify it one more time. Okay, so you can see that our related JSON is ready, and I'm gonna say it's dash JSON so that when we look into database we can, you know, differentiate it. All right, so if I click on send, it will connect to database and it will create relational data for the JSON that I just sent. And you can see that now it has publisher ID, book ID, and then publisher ID associated with the book, and then a publisher ID associated with book, and then sales associated with the book, and created ID. If you go into your database, if I look up for the data, then you can see that it created Harper Brothers JSON publisher, which has publisher ID 35, and it will also have books associated with publisher ID for publisher ID 35. So this is how you can save related data using Entity Framework Core. If you have any questions, you can reach out to me on Twitter or Facebook, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Thanks for watching.